All right, so stochastic games are more general than other models that we've talked about. And so just to make that case, here's a way of making the stochastic game settings more constrained, and by making them more constrained, actually turning them into other models that we've talked about or could talk about. So I wrote down three different ways of constraining the stochastic game model. One says that we're going to make the reward function for one player the opposite of the reward function for the other. The next one says that the transition function has the property that for any state and joint action and next state, that's going to be equal to the transition probability for state, joint action, next state, where we've changed potentially the choice of action for player two.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, player two doesn't matter to the transitions or the rewards for player one, and the rewards for player two are always zero. So mm-hmm. that's again, you can specify this as a stochastic game. And then the third case, we are saying that the number of states in the environment is exactly one.
Mm.
So I claim that by doing these restrictions, we get out the Markov decision process model, a zero-sum stochastic game model, and the repeated game model that we've been talking about in the context of like the folk theorem. So what I'd like you to do is write the letters A, B, and C in the correct boxes.
Okay.
Go.